Welcome to another episode of The Power of Better, brought to you by Powering Chicago. I'm Elbert Walters III, the Executive Director of Powering Chicago, and your host for this program on our YouTube channel, where we highlight innovation, technology, and process improvements within the electrical industry to assist end users, developers, architects, and facility managers. In this episode, we'll explore the latest clean energy initiatives. We're here at the IBEW NECA Technical Institute in ALSIP, where the union electricians of tomorrow are learning the latest advances in sustainable projects like solar. One such project is currently under construction at Advocate South Suburban Hospital in Hazel Crest. They're using solar panels to help power a facility where saving lives is a top priority. The sprawling Advocate South Suburban Medical Campus in Hazel Crest boasts a high-tech hospital and buildings housing the latest advanced medical equipment. But this hospital is different than most, as construction has begun on a solar field, which will help power the hospital for years to come. 1,400 solar panels, when complete, will account for up to 700 kilowatt hours of yearly electrical usage.
Bigger picture, Advocate Aurora has a goal to be 100% renewable electricity by 2030. So it ties directly back to the health of our patients and our populations. So a healthier environment from renewable electricity leads to healthier patients, healthier population.
With that goal in mind, Advocate's Director of Facility Operations, Austin Rennick, states, when fully operational, this solar array will provide 5% of the hospital's electricity. To help make this energy-saving project a possibility, portions of the construction were funded through Illinois' Solar for All project.
The Illinois Solar for All program provides funding to help bring down the cost and the impact to the installation of the solar array. It's directly targeted at communities that are considered low-income or environmental justice communities.
To execute this ambitious plan, Advocate hired RJL Group of Oak Lawn, a signatory women-owned electrical contractor with an assist from Pieper Construction out of Wisconsin.
The crew from Pieper will be tying in the DC power into inverters. The inverters will go to the main disconnect at the plant. From there, disconnects down to the main gear. As the shutoff, it'll tie into where the ComEd comes into the main switch gear.
The perfect partnership of Pieper and RJL Group reveals the solar expertise of the unionized electrical industry.
3 years exclusively, I've been doing nothing but solar. So a lot of those projects, we've gone up to about 6 megawatts on a single installation.
There are obvious reasons for a project like this: decreasing the hospital's carbon footprint and removing some of the electrical demand from the community grid, which will drive down costs.
It would definitely put a little dent in their energy cost, for sure, and supplement whatever maybe an emergency need, because they could use the suns here all the time, can feed a battery system, and they'd have battery backup for specific things that they want to power.
Here's how Illinois Solar for All works. Advocate South Suburban Hospital buys power directly from the developer at a 60% discount for 10 years. The developer then sees a 25 to 30% federal rebate.
We purchase the energy from the developer. The developer then owns it. Now, I mentioned that earlier, the requirement is that they sell that energy to us at a discount from what we pay Commonwealth Edison or what we pay our supplier. So they are providing us that energy at about a 60% discount.
For general contractors, this new emphasis on solar means making sure their union electricians are properly trained for a whole new segment of business.
I think this is really cool, a new technology obviously that's coming out that's becoming a big part of the market. It's always interesting to learn new systems, new technologies.
So you may be wondering, how efficient will solar be in a place like Chicago that has long, cold, dark winters?
So we figure about 10% loss, which a lot of people would figure, hey, it's gonna get buried underneath the snow, I'm gonna lose production altogether. It's not the case. Even if it's under about 6 inches of snow, you're still gonna get production out of it because you can't turn the sun off. So outside of functioning at night, that array is gonna produce as often as it can.
For all the key stakeholders, watching this come to fruition brings them great joy. And with another 1,400 solar panels soon to be installed right next to this array, Advocate South Suburban will eventually be running on 10% solar. But for Austin, that's not the most important part.
The renewable energy piece, the electricity, the savings, that's all great. The fact that so far we've made all of this construction work, we've had all this activity with no impact to ambulance traffic, no impact to patient traffic, no complaints from patients or visitors or doctors, it is the biggest win, I'd say, for us.
Sustainable, more environmentally friendly construction projects are on the rise in Chicago and Cook County. However, developers and owners may find it difficult to fund such necessary upgrades in the current financial climate. Having access to additional funding sources is paramount. Illinois Solar for All, or CPACE, are programs that can be the windfall you need. CPACE, or Commercial Property Assessed Clean Energy, is organized at the state and local levels and is essentially borrowed capital for investment in local businesses, energy and cost savings, and job creation. In fact, CPACE is helping redevelop a crumbling Bridgeport theater, transforming it into a live entertainment space, restaurant, and brewery. The 1,500-seat Ramova Theater was finished in 1929. It was once a bustling cornerstone of the Bridgeport neighborhood. After falling on hard times, it shuttered in 1986. Broken, battered, and beleaguered, it was bought by a group led by Tyler Nevis in 2021.
We realized it might fit what we really wanted to do, which is about a 1,500 to 2,000 person live music venue. The second was location. It's very easy to get to. It's in a great part of Chicago, in a very diverse community that's got a lot of history.
Looking for any and all investment funding, including multiple investors like Quincy Jones, Nevis soon learned of another option, CPACE, or Commercial Property Assessed Clean Energy.
It can finance up to 100% of any clean energy project, including energy efficiencies, renewable energies, water conservation, and resiliency type projects.
Anna Maria Kowalik is a senior vice president of the Illinois Energy Conservation Authority. The IECA is a nonprofit created for niche financing for clean energy projects like this in 14 Illinois counties and counting.
One would have to take a look at all the various resources available to them, including pairing with a capital provider, because that's where the monies come from. This is private equity investment in private projects.
That funder must then partner with a developer who hires the general contractor. In this case, McHugh Construction, whose project manager is Jennifer G. Jennifer says the funding from CPACE is about a third of this multi-million dollar project.
I think that this type of funding does help projects get off the ground that otherwise would not. You know, because 35%, 37%, or whatever the percentage is, that's a nice amount of funding to add, you know, to do restorations, especially for a building like this.
To complete a project of this scope, McHugh had to hire the very best subcontractors, like JMS Electric, to perform all of the electrical work.
Our job is to provide the entire electrical system, which includes the power, the lighting, and the base systems for the communication and data.
Including removing and restoring the iconic Ramova Theater marquee. The project architect, Dan O'Reilly, had to navigate the delicate process of preserving Ramova's landmark status while embracing CPACE's clean energy requirements.
And I think that is always going to be beneficial. I think it's always going to be a superior design product. And I think it's consistent with the very reason why you would choose to put a project in an existing building rather than do ground up construction someplace else.
When the redevelopment is complete by the summer of 2023, Ramova will be transformed into a contemporary and sustainable music venue, club, grill, and brewing company.
We wanted to remember and celebrate what Ramova looked like in the past, but we also wanted to do that in a way that really prepared for the future, you know, as small a footprint as possible.
And though the 11-year-old CPACE program has funded 2,700 projects nationwide, its supporters believe more needs to be done to educate developers, owners, and contractors.
Getting the word out there and really getting people to understand what CPACE is, how it works, and how beneficial it can be to them.
The way CPACE is set up, it lends itself really, really well for projects like this, and it made it quite a bit easier than it would have been without CPACE.
If you would like to learn more about CPACE funding in Chicago, Cook County, and the state of Illinois, please go to www.iecapace.org. You can also find more impactful information like this and so much more by visiting poweringchicago.com. That will do it for another episode of The Power of Better. I'm Elbert Walters III, and on behalf of Powering Chicago, thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time.